Welcome to the SMKR Old School Star Wars Group Build AMT / MPC AT-AT Build Number 6. Not number 5, not number 7, but number 6. Holy crap. Alright, so I got this package today from Gary, my good friend, and let's see what it says here. He gives me instructions. All right, this is an unboxing video. Number one, pull out foam packing from sides. Number two, pull out foam safety block from the sides. Number three, enjoy model. Four, watch some anime and eat noodles. Okay, check this out. So here's number one. Okay, so it says this side up. Use the force. There's a little Star Destroyer and there's a happy looking R2 there. That's awesome, dude. Oh my crap from hell. And it says number two, cut here. Okay. Alright. Oh gosh. It says, Greggy, Misa love you. Muy muy. Misa being best friends. God, I hate Jar Jar. But I love Gary. Oh gosh. Alright, let's get the X-Acto blade going here. And then we'll just stab Jar Jar in the head here. There, just to make sure he's not gonna come alive or anything.
Misa all sparkly glowy!
Alright, so cut here, like you said. Cut here. Oh gosh. Holy crap. Oh, Gary, you are totally awesome. Oh, my crap. Oh, push down here. Oh, my crap. Oh, this is beautiful. Don't ever let me drop this or destroy it or anything. Oh, God. Oh, this is so cool. I'm going to switch to close focus here. Stay tuned. Okay, so please pay attention to the magnificent detail here. Oh my crap. He really, really sculpted the crap out of this. There's no way I can even come close to doing this. This is so fantastic. Alright, so he redid all the panel lines, as you can see. And these, he put little greeblies on here even. Golly. These are matching the old MPC star, the old MPC snowspeeder model, the large model, and I have that as well. Let me get this in frame here. Oh my gosh, so he's got the cannon. And so here we go. Pop this out here. Here's the harpoon gun. Oh dear God. This is so magnificent. Look at that. And he's got the air brakes here. He's got the air brakes on little flaps. And these go into the bottom here. Somewhere. Yeah, they go in here. There's holes. I'm sorry, this is not even in frame here. Okay, so there's holes in here, run here, one here, and that's where the air brakes go into. And this little hole is, of course, is for the tow cable. Now you can see here, this is completely round on both sides. It's so fantastic. It's so incredibly awesome. So yeah, these air brakes are just really, really cool. He's labeled them here, left and right, air brakes. Oh golly. Alright, I really, really would like to go ahead and assemble this. First, I need to wash off any sort of, release mold agent and stuff, though, first. So, I'm going to get my fine molds cleaner. Look at that. That is so incredibly cool. That is so awesome. That means I can just, like, you know, paint this separately even. This is so cool. So awesome. Okay, I'm just gonna let this soak for 30 seconds. Got the mold release going. Yay. I left the right one in the bag because I don't want to accidentally get these mixed up, you know? Because I am pretty goofy. Just flip this guy over. Beautiful.
So this is on the bottom of the box. It says, "Not the top. Do not open from this side unless you wish to have nightmares of Jar Jar Binks. You have been warned."
Misa called Jar Jar Binks. Misa freaking stupid. Misa annoying. Misa bad idea.
Now, the problem is that it is now December 12th, and I am still working on this thing. So I think for the build, I'm just going to complete the model and the diorama is going to have to come later, I think. And hopefully these things will fit together okay. Is this there's certain ways that these things are maybe I should have paid attention to the numbers, I think. Yeah. Okay, I think this is gonna have to go this way. These actually do make pairs. Okay. Okay. There. Okay. I got some flash here. I'm gonna have to file down too. And I think I'm gonna have to put the clamps on this guy here. Where the heck were my clamps? Put the clamps on him. Man, this is not wanting to go together. Look at this. I am totally struggling here. Is it just a matter of not enough glue? I don't know. There. Okay. So I have improved this considerably. Now what I did last night is I clamped these things down and I used plenty of Mr. Surfacer 500 to get into the cracks. And let's work on this thing here. This is acetone that I am rubbing, and so the Mr. Surfacer will just stay in the crack and the outside will be kind of smoothed down, if not removed. But I don't think I need to completely remove it. It's okay. And, So I had like really, really obvious gaping holes, like cracks in here, and it does not look good. But now this is pretty nice here. The only problem is they got some flash or whatever where the parts do not line up right. So just gotta sand this down with 180 grit sandpaper to smooth this out. There we go. So yeah, I'm just gonna keep working on it like this, and then I'll show you what it looks like once I'm done. So already it's looking a lot smoother. Actually, with a fit issue like this, it's probably best just to use the file, because there is quite a lot that kind of sticks out. So yeah, I'm going to use this and then go over it with the sandpaper, because this part is a bit more uneven than this one was. And to get on the inside, I'm going to use the curved file here to get in like this. Okay, so I am still working on sanding this and making this smooth and hopefully kind of restoring this. I've primed it and puttied it and primed it again, and I'm still kind of working on the putty here. So there's a couple of inaccuracies. Now, for some reason, there's only like this flap thing here, but there's nothing on this side. It's kind of strange. I'm not sure why that they sculpted the AT-AT in such a way. Maybe one of the props that they were using only had one, or maybe it fell off or something. I don't know. Now, there's something that's missing here. There's like a T-shaped thing that kind of hangs down. And you can see it on this doohickey here. It just kind of hangs down here. Now, it's also visible on the F-Toys. Now, there's, you can kind of see it here, right? So, yeah, we're kind of, you know, missing out on something here. Now, I bought this stuff called Plop Plate. This is made by Tommy, as you can see. And, it comes with several different layers here, so you can see what it looks like here. Plop plate. Okay. And it has different thicknesses. So there's one that's like really thick. It's like 1.2 1.2 millimeters thick. And then there's two that are half a millimeter, and there are two that are 0.3 millimeters. So, what I did was I measured this here, and it came out to be 22 millimeters. So, what I did was I marked this here, and I just used just like this pen here, 22 millimeters. Then I went down like a centimeter here, and then I went like maybe 2 or whatever it was. I can't remember what the numbers were, maybe like 3 millimeters or so. And that's where I came up with this here. Yeah, this is like maybe half a centimeter, and then this is like maybe 2 or 3 millimeters. Then I counted like 6 millimeters in either way, and then I counted another 7 down, and that's where I got this shape here. So what I'm going to try to do is cut this out, and I hope this will look decent. Now, it does not bend down over the lip, but I'll heat the plastic up in warm water, and it should be able to be bent that way. Now, let me, there, so I can see what I'm doing here. Okay. So, let me get my trusty cutter here. I don't trust it that much. Alright. Now let's make a cut along this line here. Wait, can you see this okay? Let me get closer here. There. You're looking at the tripod. The leg of the tripod. It's great, huh? Okay, so I think this is flush. Let's cut this. Oh, jeez. Alright. This is going to be a little bit tricky. It's kind of thick. It's not as easy. Oh, look at that. I think I cut my snippy... Slice it slightly. That's not good. I don't have any, like, metal. Or do I? I do. Yeah, I do. I totally do. Where's the Hasegawa thingy? It's in here somewhere. Oh, this is, like, so thin, though. I don't know if this is really good to use or not. I think I might as well, keep using what I'm using here. Okay. There. Now. There. Okay, let's see if this comes out or not by itself. There we go. Great. Okay, so I have these two little indentations here. Make a cut here. There. And then make another cut here. There. I'll see if I can cut this here. Hopefully this isn't gonna look like crap. Oh, I already did that. Now I'm moving on up now. Out of the darkness. The thing is, it's like one side of this is like really glossy and shiny, and the other side is kind of dull. It's kind of weird. But I think this looks pretty clean. Now, what I want to do is have this up here and hang down, and then I should be good to go. I think I got some 400 grit sandpaper here. What I can do is kind of smooth out this. I don't think this cut really evenly. Yeah, okay, it feels better now. Yeah, okay, let's go get some hot water and soak this sucker. Okay, I have been soaking this in hot water for a while now. Now what I want to do is see if this will... Yeah, I had the camera bends, that's for sure. There. Okay, let's see if this will bend or not. I'm just going to put this over that ledge of the desk here. And try to bend this. I think I need to get this hotter, I think. Maybe some boiling hot, super hot water, maybe. This is not warm enough. Okay, so I apologize that this was kind of off camera, but what I did was just bent the thing over the roller here when it was nice and warm. And could maybe kind of warm it up a little bit more again, I guess. And do it some more, but it stresses the plastic, but it doesn't like break it or anything, so it that's what's best for it. So already you can see that if this goes on here, it I just need to push it down some more, but this is gonna fit just fine in this space here and kind of bend downwards. I need to prime it, of course, but it looks pretty nice. Okay, so what you see here is the finished result. It has been affixed to the to the model here. Now, there's a little bit of a crack running along here, unfortunately. But it's okay, I think. So what I did was I puttied it here, where there was like a bit of a crack, and I'm going to... actually, no, I don't think that's a crack. I think it's just the where the plastic was stressed. Yeah, it should be okay. So I puttied it here, and then I just sanded it smooth. So I can't feel anything with my finger. So I'm just going to reprime this area, and then I will be ready to go with the main body paint. But actually, before that, I want to do some pre-shading in here. So that's what's going to be next. Okay, so as you can see, that crack has pretty much disappeared now. So I am feeling a lot better about it. So what I want to do is do some pre-shading and all of these contraptions here. All of this detail and such. So let's go ahead and do that. I'm going to be working with Mr. Color 33 Flat Black. Again, this is lacquer. That will finish it for the pre-shading, I believe. I am pretty satisfied with that. Now, I've been thinking about what I'm going to paint this thing. And originally I was thinking Aircraft Gray, Mr. Color 73. But it seems like most of the Mr. Color paints that I have are like a real cool kind of a gray. And but looking at the scenes in which the AT-ATs are in the full daylight, they seem to be a little bit warmer. And so what I'm going to do, I think, I'm going to paint mine, this is Tamiya TS-81
Royal Light Gray. I'm going to try this to paint my my AT-AT here. As for the other AT-AT, I'm going to try to strip the paint off of that and paint that up as well along with this. So, you know what? Actually, oh my gosh, I just, look at this. I missed little portal things up there. I want to make sure to get these guys here. There. This one can stand to be a little bit darker. Did I get these on the top here? No, I did not. Oh my gosh. So anyhow, I'm going to end this video here. And I'll hopefully work on this more during the winter vacation. I got a couple more days of work. It's been a nice weekend. I got to see the new Star Wars movie. I pretty much more or less liked it. This is the, you know, finally a decent Star Wars movie. I think it has some flaws in it, but overall, I kind of enjoyed it. So, I didn't get any goosebumps when the title came along, or the text crawl, or anything like that. Unfortunately, the prequels have pretty much killed that with me. But, overall, I kind of liked the movie. I thought it was pretty decent. Anyhow, I'll give my opinions on that later, I suppose. Maybe in another video. So, anyhow, this is it for appreciating, and I thank you for watching, and stay tuned. P.S. This is something my daughter wrote. See, like, this, she wrote her name, Ulan, and drew a cute little picture there. And over here, these are the two movies that she wants to see. This is the Japanese title for the Peanuts movie is I Love Snoopy. Or this is right here, Peanuts, and there's Snoopy. And then Star Wars, and there's R2-D2. So these are the two movies that I've been excited to see this month, and my daughter as well. So that's pretty cute. Bye.